Your honest opinion on this.
Ooh. All right. Well, it's undeniable. It is a beautiful stone. It's got a lot of clarity. It's got some fire. You think a woman of your grace should have something a little bit more impressive. Why don't you talk your fellow
assistant? Excuse me, Mr. Caine.
Look, you'll have to excuse me a moment. Darling, why don't you keep the party going? I'll talk to you later.
All right.
I'll show you those stones. Okay.
Keep up.
Let's go.
Garret, what was that?
Sound like a man's scream. Over there. Come on.
I swear to God.
Shut the fuck up!
Please, Mr. Caine.
Oh, please. You know what your trouble is, Bob?
Please don't.
You got no heart.
No!
Get out of here.
Come on, find out who that is. Thanks, Garret. You saved my life. Why can't they leave us alone? We didn't do anything.
I know, Paulie. Come on, we gotta keep going.
Oh my God!
off. We have to rappel down. Come on.
He's got the diamonds. Go stop him. Get him. He's got the diamonds. Bring him back to me.
Mr. Caine, is everything all right?
Yes, Mr. Sanji. What do you ask?
You seem to be a little upset.
No, everything is okay.
Please excuse my overeager concerns. It's just that $1 million is quite a substantial amount of money, especially when it's only a deposit. You understand?
I understand perfectly well your investment is safe. Your diamonds will be here 1 week from tomorrow, as promised. Now, if you don't mind, I've got my own business to attend to. Excuse me.
Good, then I guess you won't have any objections to Mac here assisting in your efforts. I like to think of Mac as my insurance. Now, you're a businessman. I'm sure you understand.
Yes, Mr. Sanji, I understand.
Hey, are you gonna play loops all day? Are you even gonna answer the phone?
Marty, I'm gonna need a couple days off.
Maybe more than a couple.
It's 92.3 KSJO and the Parole Violator coming at you. We have some more heavy metal rock and roll by request.
Sorry about your friend.
Yeah, me too.
You gonna be okay?
I'm okay. I just need some time off.
I think you need a break too. You should ask Uncle Masty. He could always use the overtime. Well, let me know if there's anything you need.
Mindy?
Yeah?
Thanks.
Why is it I always end up doing your job? Can you explain that to me? Now listen. Looks like our fat friend is finally gonna get a proper burial. And I'm certain his Rambo buddy is gonna attend, so I want the both of you to be there. Pay my condolences. Get my fucking diamonds back!
Sir.
What?
There's a call for you.
Hello? Mr. Sanji. Yes, sir. No. Everything is going off as planned. We're going ahead. Don't worry about it. Fine. I'll call you. Yes, sir. Yes, goodbye.
TJ, I got a bad feeling.
I'm here for you.
Remember these pictures of you, Paulie, and Carrie?
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
You remember when Paulie got stuck up in a tree, we had to call the fire department.
Yeah.
Garrett, I want you to get the people who did this to my son. I love that kid. When Paulie's mother took Carrie away, it killed me. And now my son is gone. I'm all alone.
I'm here, Blake. I'll make things right. I promise. Maybe you should stay with me for a couple days.
I'll be all right, kid. Looks like your theory was a waste of the department's time, Garrett.
And what have you done to find my son's killer?
Whoa, back up, Pops.
It's been a week and you haven't got shit.
Listen, Blake, forensics turned up nothing. No casings, no blood, no bodies. The parole violator here gave me something more than some mob-style execution. A missing wallet is probably under a bloody bar stool somewhere. And the theory that the bad guys are going to show up here to eliminate the witnesses, maybe I'd have your killer.
You're full of shit, Lon. You know that?
Don't be coming down on me, Blake. You're the one that drunk yourself off the force. As for you, Garrett, you spin the records. Let me do the detective work. You got that? We're out of here. Don't pay any attention to him, kid. All that dick's got is excuses, lazy bastard.
Yeah. I'll see you in a while.
Right. I thought that gets your attention. Looked like it worked.
Blake's been shot.
Shot? What? What happened? Where are you?
I'm at home. Come over. There's some things I have to tell you. I gotta go.
What?
What the hell is this? This? This is why Polly's dead. Why Blake's in the hospital.
Why didn't you tell me about the diamonds before?
I don't know. But I do know that these guys aren't gonna get away with this.
Garrett, this is serious. Why don't you let Lon and the department handle this?
Lon? That idiot could have stopped Blake from getting shot.
This is from the sniper. Took it off him at the graveyard.
I'll run him through the computer. I'll see what I can come up with.
We can get these guys, TJ.
Expect the unexpected.
What's more champagne?
Victor are dead. Kid got away.
Dead. I told you to personally know Luke. We'll talk about this later. Now we really have an important meeting to take. Let's go. When you are, Mac.
For those of you who are unaware, the plans have changed. No longer will the heist be taking place through the front door. We'll be going in through the roof.
Who's this guy?
I want you to meet Mac. He works close with Mr. Sanjay. For the time being, he's going to help us keep our customers happy.
That's right. Now, the roof. It's safe, and it's fast. They won't know what hit him. We'll be in and out before they know it.
We don't need any outside help.
Look, I want the both of you to cooperate with me. And you do exactly what he says. I don't want any further complications. All right, let's go through this again.
lawn. Forensics found these on the rocks about 20 feet from where Polly's body fell. Oh, yeah, and here's that file on Louis Misanti you wanted.
Yeah, thank you, Lily.
See you tomorrow.
Good night, Lily. Yeah, Bill? Lon Anderson in homicide. How you doing? Listen, can you do me a favor and check and see if anybody accessed the Misanti file in the last few days? Codename Gray Fox. Yeah. TJ Boyle. Great. Thanks, Bill.
Is Caine a dick?
Hey, we're all clear out back.
Right?
Yeah, yeah. Let's go.
I'll cover you. Keep an eye on the dead guys.
Get away?
Yeah.
Shit! Well, nope, the party's over. You mind telling me what's going on?
What are you talking about?
What are you doing? I'm looking for Garret. If you two fuck up this investigation, you're both going down. You understand me?
You're barking up the wrong tree, Lon.
Barking?
barking up the wrong tree? Like a gray fox, huh? You need a new computer access code, TJ.
Like I said, I don't know what you're talking about. But it sounds like you're onto something pretty big. You let me know if you need any help.
Better watch your ass, TJ. You're walking the wrong side of the thin blue line, pal. Rookies.
Hello, Garret.
You're a little late, aren't you?
Can I come up?
Yeah. We missed you at the funeral. Dad missed you.
I just came from the cemetery. I didn't know I'd feel so bad, you know. Not being there for Paulie.
It's a little more than Paulie, Carrie. Blake's still your father.
It's not my fault he drank his family away.
He loved you, believe it or not. He needed your support.
Listen, Garret, I didn't come here to hear your speech about my family problems. I came to find out who killed my brother.
It's under investigation.
Well, what's being done?
Listen, Carrie. Hello? Yeah. Where do you want to meet? Okay, in about 30 minutes. All right, bye. I'm sorry, Carrie. I didn't mean to lecture you. Look, I gotta get going. Do you have a place to stay?
No, not yet.
Why don't you stay here? Make yourself comfortable. When I get back, we can talk over dinner.
His name is John Caine. FBI's been trying to nail his organization for about 7 years now. Take a look at this. These are his two right-hand men. This guy right here, that's Luke. The guy with the knife they call Blade.
Caine, huh?
Here's the file on the dead guy at the graveyard. His name is Louis Masante. He's Caine's number one shooter. And take a look at this one. All of these robberies took place over the last 6 months. All of them matching the same M.O., all of them by Caine and company. Garret,
long has that office been for lease?
5-6 months?
Come on.
What?
What's up, Garrett? What are you thinking?
Still have that security surveillance system?
Yeah. Why?
We're going into the diamond business.
Would you like some more coffee?
Yes, I would, please. Thank you.
You're welcome. Excuse me, sir. There's no smoking. Hey.
You say we get some Chinese food?
How about Mexican? Is that a yes?
That's a yes.
Find those diamonds. Let's go.
Hey, Garrett. How you doing?
Daniel.
Coming to eat tonight?
Yeah.
There you go. Enjoy.
Thanks. This is a nice place.
Yeah.
The menu looks good. What do you recommend?
Let's go on the balcony. The view's great. We can see the mountains.
Oh my gosh, the view is beautiful. Thanks. Wow.
Did you take my order? I need to use the bathroom.
Yeah.
I'll have 2 chicken tacos.
Okay.
Oh.
with them. Garrett, I wish you'd tell me what's going on here.
Don't ask. The less you know, the safer you are.
Does this have something to do with Paulie's murder? It does, doesn't it? I want to know what the hell's going on.
You need to stay out of it. It's gotten too far out of hand.
I don't really care. This is my brother we're talking about.
It's too late for your brother. Get to know your dad. You're all he's got.
Garrett, don't give me the runaround. I'm out of here.
Is Nasty in?
Hold on one second. Silver boots? No way, what a slut. Who is she with?
Solid rock and roll 92.3 KSJO. Turn it up!
Nasty.
Yes! Hey, bro, what's up? Where the hell you been, man? Everybody's looking for you.
I need you to plug this for me. Every hour on the hour, starting at 11 a.m. I need all the airtime I can get.
What's up with this?
I can't explain. Will you do it?
My man, but you're gonna owe me a buzz for this.
You're on. Thanks.
fuck that guy think he is? Go through the roof. Mac, sound like a fucking hamburger.
Fuck him, punk. He'll screw up and Caine will have us take him out same way he does every other asshole he hires. Look, this is the fucking mom and pop establishment. We're not gonna get any money out of this place. Let's go.
Who you went to jail is you save at Diamonds, where we've got millions of dollars in inventory of loose and exotic stones ready to move.
You hear that?
Heard of low prices.
Yeah.
So
hurry loud.
Up.
Good music.
This weekend at the town
the advertisement. Vincent.
Bleed. You call me Bleed. I want to be called Bleed.
I'm not calling you that. Vinny, how long I known you? I'm not calling you Bleed. Let's go.
I want to be called Bleed.
Give it to me.
We got a lead.
Hey, Luke's got a lead. Boy, I gotta really hear this one.
It's a reliable source. A new diamond store opening up this weekend.
It's downtown. It's gonna be a shitload.
You know, you guys are really starting to bore me. Now I want some results. Get me some diamonds. And Blade, Mr. Sanji's getting too close. I want you to take Mac and his boys out. Make it look like an accident. Oh, please put that thing away before you cut somebody with it.
He calls me Blade.
Shut up, Vincent.
I think we need to speak to Mr. Sanji and let him know his investment's a bad one.
Now for the monitors.
Cleaning crew, two security cameras, no security guards.
This is gonna be easy.
Hey,
Good to see you. Been here long?
Yeah, but I just wanted to make sure you're gonna be okay.
God, I'm sorry for all the grief I caused you.
Let's just get you back on your feet now, okay?
I'm okay. It's Garrett you should be worried about.
Garrett's up to something.
I asked Garrett to go after the people who did this to Paulie.
Oh, Daddy, that was not a good idea.
Yeah, maybe it was a mistake.
I should try to stop him.
Go.
Look, Marty, I gave you my word. My word is my bond. The goods will be there by the end of the week. You got nothing to worry about. Just a minute. What, baby? What's troubling?
Mr. Sanjay is here.
Look, Marty, I'll have to get back to you. Don't worry, I'll call you at the end of the week.
He's brought some men with him, and they're in the dining room. He's not happy.
Expect the unexpected. Mike.
Mr. Sanjay. I wasn't expecting you for a couple of days. What's on your mind?
I received some disturbing news, Caine. I have a feeling I'm never going to see the diamonds you promised me, or for that matter, the cash deposit.
Sanjay, you call me a thief.
I just want my deposit back.
Garrett.
Wait a minute.
What the fuck's this? Let's go. You sure you pulled the right plug? What are you talking about? Look, man! Let's go!
Shopping? We're closed.
way in. We got the diamonds.
They're on their way.
I'm gonna go show Caine the diamonds. Take her upstairs.
God, get your hands off of me!
Go.
You don't want to know. That punk and his cop friend showed up. There was no exotic display, and it was a setup. But I did get your diamonds back.
What is this?
What?
Makeup.
Makeup?
Some kind of sick fucking joke or what?
Mr. Caine, I swear to God the diamonds were in that bag. You can ask Vincent. He's upstairs with the guy's girl right now.
Let's go.
Want to feel the blade? Drop the gun.
my purse. You gonna catch me?
Yeah, I promise.
Okay.
Vincent!
Vinny? Blade?
Where's the girl? Go find the girl.
Go find the girl!
Sonny, bring the truck around.
Move!
Everything's gone.
Leave this house alive. You hear me?
Yeah.
You two, go over there. You, come with me.
Oh my God, there's so many of them, Garrett.
Yeah, I counted about 10.
How many bullets have you got?
3.
Make them count.
I know where to get more.
Donnie,
go around and cover the back. The rest of you go up the side. I don't want the son of a bitch dead.
You know, your friend Paulie's got a really cute scream. All the way down.
Go ahead, we'll go get judged together.
Right?
Yeah, I'm a little tired of hanging around though.
This is your Uncle Nasty. You'll never believe what has just happened to me. I have been sentenced. That's right, a life of working the day shift while your old friend, the parole violator, has been convicted to serve a life sentence in paradise. Right on, bro. Some guy's got all the luck.
Hey. Thank you.